हाय बच्चों, दिस इज प्रोफेसर आरिफ खान इन एसोसिएशन विद सिनाल्स क्लासेस. लेट अस बिगिन विद अनदर चैप्टर. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद रेशियो प्रोपोर्शन टुडे एंड लेट्स लर्न विद अ स्माइल. लेट्स बिगिन. आई हैव टेकन अ नंबर 15 अपॉन 35. नाउ दिस इज अ फ्रैक्शन. इन दिस फ्रैक्शन there is a common factor 5. If I cancel the common factor 5, I get a ratio 3:7. This is what we call as a ratio, where 3 is the antecedent, 7 is the consequent, and this is a sign of is to. So a ratio is always antecedent, is to, consequent. That is what we have. Now let us talk about two different ratios. Suppose if I have 10 upon 20, or maybe 6 upon 12, or maybe 8 upon 16. Guys, if you consider these three ratios, what you see that after cancelling the common factors in all the three ratios or all the three fractions, what we get is half, half and half. That means the value of these ratios are same, which is half is equal to half is equal to half. So they all have a constant value, and this k is nothing but half. So when you have ratios with equal values, they are said to be in proportion. तो यहां पर proportion क्या होता है, let us understand that. Proportion मतलब वो ratios जिनकी values equal है, such a ratio is called as a they are said to be in proportion. Now if I have A B C D such that A upon B is equal to C upon D, A upon B is equal to C upon D, and they both have a value which is a constant K, we say that A, B, C and D are in proportion. Okay guys, now in this chapter ratio proportion, lot of things are deleted, it's been removed for this year. Now basically I've come across that students, they have a lot of confusion while understanding the various properties of componendo, dividendo, alternando, invertendo. Now what I'll do here is, I'll make things very simple for you and explain it with an example. Now let us take the case of 2 upon 4 and 3 upon 6. These two ratios are equal. We say that 2 upon 4 is equal to 3 upon 6. Why? Because their value is half. Now let us add 2 plus 4, put it upon 4, and 3 plus 6 and put it upon 6, and see, do they still have the same value? 2 plus 4 upon 4, 3 plus 6 upon 6, do they have the same value? Now 6 upon 4, 9 upon 6 is 3, 2, 3, 2. That means if I add this denominator in the numerator on both the sides, the value should be equal. So 2 plus 4 upon 4 and 3 plus 6 upon 6, they are equal. Now it means that suppose if I have first number upon second number is equal to third number upon fourth number, it means that first number plus second number
upon second number will always give us third number plus fourth number upon fourth number. Their values will be equal. And in terms of maths, in terms of our properties, we see that if A, B, C and D are first, second, third and fourth number, we find that first plus second upon second is equal to third plus fourth upon fourth. So this is the first property in proportionality. It is called as componendo. This property is called as componendo. So this property, you can relate it with this example, which exactly means this, and this is the property A plus B upon B, C plus D upon D. Now let us come to the next example. Suppose if I have 2 minus 4 upon 4 and then 3 minus 6 upon 6, what does this mean? This is minus 2 upon 4, this is minus 3 upon 6. When you cancel on both sides, you find that the answer is minus half on both sides. So this implies that if I have first number minus second number upon second number, that is equal to third number minus fourth number upon fourth number. So their values are equal. First minus second upon second is equal to third minus fourth upon fourth. So here, this is our first number, first minus second upon second, third minus fourth upon fourth. You can relate it this way. You can move this way and you can get this result. This result in proportionality is called as dividendo. So when you are adding a denominator with the numerator, it is componendo. When you are subtracting a denominator with the numerator, it is called as dividendo. Now let us come to the third property. The third property states that if you add the denominator in the numerator and then you subtract the denominator from the numerator. Matlab aap kya kar rahe ho bachcho? First my plus second, first plus second upon first minus second, first plus second upon फर्स्ट माइनस सेकेंड, और फिर आप क्या करते हो, थर्ड प्लस फोर्थ अपॉन थर्ड माइनस फोर्थ. आर दे स्टिल इक्वल? यू कैन चेक. सिक्स अपॉन माइनस टू एंड नाइन अपॉन माइनस थ्री, द आंसर ऑन बोथ द साइड इज स्टिल माइनस थ्री, सो दे आर इक्वल. मतलब न्यूमरेटर में आप डिनोमिनेटर को ऐड करो और सब्ट्रैक्ट करो, नीचे ऊपर ऐड करो और नीचे सब्ट्रैक्ट करो डिनोमिनेटर को, यू फाइंड दैट द रिजल्ट इज स्टिल इक्वल. सो वी से दैट फर्स्ट प्लस सेकेंड अपॉन फर्स्ट माइनस सेकेंड इज इक्वल टू थर्ड प्लस फोर्थ अपॉन थर्ड माइनस फोर्थ, विच इज गिवन एज दिस. फर्स्ट प्लस सेकेंड अपॉन फर्स्ट माइनस सेकेंड इज इक्वल टू थर्ड प्लस फोर्थ अपॉन थर्ड माइनस फोर्थ, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज componendo dividendo. Then we come to the fourth property. Now in this fourth property, what you see is shift the alternate positions of a numerator with a denominator. Shift 3 here and 4 there. So what do you get? 2 upon 3, 4 upon 6. बच्चों आप 3 को नीचे ले आए, 4 को ऊपर ले गए. अब चेक करो क्या दोनों का आंसर सेम है. 2 2 सा 2 3 सा, यस बोथ द साइड्स द आंसर इज स्टिल द सेम. सो व्हेन यू चेंज द अल्टरनेट पोजीशंस ऑफ अ डिनोमिनेटर विद अ न्यूमरेटर, द आंसर इज स्टिल द सेम. लेट अस अप्लाई दिस ऑन दिस साइड. व्हाट वी गेट इज फर्स्ट अपॉन थर्ड is equal to second upon fourth. First upon third is equal to second upon fourth. So that implies here A, B, C, D, first, second, third, fourth, bring C here and shift B on the other side. So we get first upon third is equal to second upon fourth. This is called as alternando.
And finally, just take the reciprocals, the multiplicative inverses. Just take the reciprocals. When you take the reciprocals on both the sides, you get 4 upon 2, 6 upon 3. Find the values of each. Here also the answer is 2. There also the answer is 2. So the answers are equal. Do the same thing here. First upon second is equal to third upon fourth. So that becomes second upon first is equal to fourth upon third. So they'll also be equal. So likewise, that's what I've done here. If it is A upon B is equal to C upon D, and you take the reciprocal, you will get B upon A is equal to D upon C. Now, since you have inverted the ratios, the property is called as invertendo. So my dear friends, these are the five properties that we start with in ratio proportion. Remember this, if you are having two ratios which are equal, which means if you are having two ratios in proportion, if you add the denominator on both sides, if you only add the denominator on both sides, the ratios are equal, the ratios are equal, there is an equality sign in between, and this property is called as componendo. Yani componendo means denominator ko dono side mein upar le jakar add karna. Dividendo means denominator is to be taken in the with the numerator and subtracted on both sides. So denominator ko aap upar le jaake minus kar do, dividend ho gaya. If you add the denominator and then subtract the denominator, ek bar aap add karo, ek bar subtract karo, dono taraf, dono side mein, the answer is still the same. This property is called as componendo dividendo. Next, if you change the alternate positions of a numerator with a denominator, of a numerator with a denominator, this is a change of alternate positions. It is called as alternando. And when you invert the ratios on both sides, the answer is still the same, and this is called as invertendo. So these are the five properties that we learn in the very beginning: componendo, dividendo, componendo, dividendo, alternando, and invertendo. Last time repeat kar raha hu. Componendo, denominator ko upar le jaake plus karo. Dividendo, denominator को ऊपर ले जाके माइनस करो. Componendo, dividendo, denominator को ऊपर ले जाके प्लस करो और नीचे ले जाके माइनस करो. Alternando, एक alternate position चेंज करो numerator की denominator के साथ. और invertendo, invertendo में what you find? That you are taking the reciprocals on both the sides. Alright, so we begin from here. Now let's solve a couple of sums using the property of componendo, dividendo and the property that we have learned here. X upon y is given as 3 upon 5. Find out the value of this first and then find out the value of this first. This is the first sum that we have here. So we begin with this. X upon y is equal to 3 upon 5. Now guys, with x upon y equal to 3 upon 5, we want to reach this result. We want to get this 2x plus 3y upon 2x minus 3y. We have x and y, but we want 2x and 3y. Hamare paas bachcho x aur y hai aur hame 2x aur 3y chahiye. So what will we do is, x ko aap multiply karoge 2 se aur y ko multiply karoge 3 se. Aisa karne se ye 2x aur 3y hame mil jayega. So the first step should be 2. You have multiplied x with 2 and y with 3. If you are doing something at the left, you will have to do the same thing on the right also. So, you multiply the right hand side also by 2 and 3. So, in this step, what you have done is multiply by 2 upon 3 on both sides. Bachcho, aapne kyun multiply kiya? Because aapko x aur y ko 2x aur 3y banana hai. 2x aur 3y kyun banana hai? Because question ke andar ye pucha gaya hai. To 2x aur 3y banane ke liye, this is the option that we have. Then
this is 2x upon 3y, this is 2 upon 5.
तो अब आप x upon y से 2x upon 3y तक पहुंच गए. इसके बाद आपको चाहिए 2x plus 3y upon 2x minus 3y. Now 2x plus 3y और 2x minus 3y के लिए what you will do is think about the properties that we have learned. ऊपर add करना है denominator को और नीचे subtract करना है denominator को. So for that what you will do is using componendo dividendo on both sides. 2x plus 3y 2x minus 3y is equal to 2 plus 5 upon 2 minus 5. What you have done here is by using componendo dividendo. And with this property, see what answer do you get. You get 2x plus 3y upon 2x minus 3y is equal to 7 upon minus 3. बच्चों, ये है आपका answer. 7 upon minus 3, which is minus 7 upon 3, obviously. So this is your first answer. Okay, guys, again, x upon y is equal to 3 upon 5 is given and you are asked to find out the value of this. So we'll write x upon y is equal to 3 upon 5. Now we want to get this 3x square minus 2y square and so on. Sabse pehle aap kya karoge bachcho? Take squares on both sides. Now when you take squares on both sides, you will get x square and y square here. So this will become x square upon y square is equal to 9 upon 25 squaring both sides. And when you are squaring both sides, this is what you get. So x upon y se aapko x square upon y square mil gaya. Now x square ke saath we need 3, y square ke saath we need 2. So we will multiply both sides by 3 upon 2. Multiply by 3 upon 2. That's what you have done on both the sides. Because ab pehle x upon y tha, x square upon y square hua. Ab isko 3x square upon 2y square karne ke liye ye humne multiply kiya. Now see what do you get. 3x square upon 2y square is equal to 27 upon 50. Bachcho ab ye 3x square aur 2y square ke format mein to aa gaya. Now we want it to get added and subtracted. एक बार ये add होना है, एक बार ये subtract होना है. तो add और subtract होने के लिए what property do we use? Componendo dividendo. हम लोग componendo dividendo use करते हैं. 3x square plus 2y square, 3x square minus 2y square, 27 plus 50, which is 77. 27 minus 50. Minus 23. So by using componendo dividendo. So componendo dividendo use kar liya aapne. Next, observe the question carefully. There is a negative sign in the numerator and positive in the denominator. लेकिन जो हमारे पास है बच्चों उसमें positive numerator में, negative denominator में. So there is another property by which you can get this negative in the numerator and positive in the denominator, and that property is invertendo. When you use invertendo, this goes up and this comes down. So you will have 3x square minus 2y square upon 3x square plus 2y square is equal to minus 23 upon 77. And guys, this is your final answer. Here what you have used? You have used by invertendo. So this is one kind of a sum that you should be acquainted with. This is one kind of a sum that you should know. Now we move on to another sum based on the same properties. Well, A upon B is given as C upon D, and we have to show that this exists. Solution, to begin with, A upon B is equal to C upon D. We start from here, this is given to us. We want 3A and 5B. So we multiply both sides by 3 upon 5. बच्चों अब ये मल्टीप्लाई करने के बाद में आप क्या करते हो देखो यू वॉन्ट 3A 5B टू बी एडेड एंड अगेन टू बी सब्ट्रैक्टेड सो यूज कंपोनेंट और डिविडेंड ऑन बोथ साइड्स By using componendo, dividendo. So you are almost close to the result. The only thing is, negative numerator में है और positive denominator में है. तो क्या करेंगे बच्चों? फिर से वही. Negative को ऊपर लाना है, positive को नीचे लाना है. Use invertendo. ये रहा बच्चों आपका रिजल्ट सो यू हैव प्रूव्ड इट ऑलराइट नाउ लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द सेम प्रॉपर्टीज दैट वी जस्ट लर्न विद दीज टू सम्स द फर्स्ट वन इज दिस वेर यू आर आस्क्ड टू सॉल्व नाउ व्हेनेवर यू आस्क्ड टू सॉल्व समथिंग दैट मीन्स यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स सो हियर वील ट्राई एंड फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स This under root 4x plus 3 plus under root x plus 1 upon under root 4x plus 3 minus under root x plus 1 is equal to 3 upon 2. This is the question given. Now, consider this term as your first number. Consider this term as your second number. This is your third number. This is your fourth number. Now, this is your first upon second, which is equal to third upon fourth. So, here, if I use componendo dividendo, the result would be this. First, plus second, upon first minus second bachcho first this is your first number plus second number, first number minus second number is equal to third number plus fourth number upon third number minus fourth number. So this is what we have by using
कंपोनेंडो डिविडेंडो. सो आई हैव यूज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कंपोनेंडो डिविडेंडो. आई हैव गॉट दिस फर्स्ट प्लस सेकेंड अपॉन फर्स्ट माइनस सेकेंड इज इक्वल टू थर्ड प्लस फोर्थ अपॉन थर्ड माइनस फोर्थ. नाउ लेट अस ओपन द ब्रैकेट एंड सॉल्व. व्हेन आई ओपन द ब्रैकेट आई वुड गेट अंडर रूट 4x plus 3 plus under root x plus 1 root 4x plus 3 minus x plus 1. See, this is plus into minus, minus. Upon 4x plus 3 minus x plus 1 minus 4x plus 3. Now this is where you need to be careful. Minus and then there's a bracket. You are opening the bracket. So minus into plus. The plus outside the root sign. Minus into plus is minus. All right. But then minus into minus is plus. Three plus two is five. 3 minus 2 is 1. Then, let's cancel this. Let's cancel this. Now, this is under root 4x plus 3. Under root 4x plus 3. There are two roots of the same kind. So, you write it as 2 root 4x plus 3 upon. Sorry, this was first term. 2 root x plus 1 is equal to 2 cancel 5 upon 1. So, bacho, ab you are in a position where you are left with this only these terms, these four terms. There's a root sign here. Whenever you come across a root sign and you find it difficult to proceed ahead, the easiest way is to remove the root sign. And the method of removing the root sign is taking squares on both the sides. You take squares on both the sides. When you are doing so, you will get under root 4x plus 3 square under root x plus 1 square is equal to 25 upon 1. What you have done here is using or say squaring both sides. So now a root and a square, it gets cancelled. So under root 4x plus 3 ka square is just 4x plus 3 upon under root x plus 1 ka square is just x plus 1, while this is 25 upon 1. Root is removed. You have got a simple equation now. Cross multiply and get the answer for x. 1 comes here. X plus 1 goes there. So you have 1 into 4x plus 3 and 25 into x plus 1. So this is 4x plus 3 is equal to 25x plus 25. 4x plus 3 is equal to 25x plus 25. Now shift 25x on this side, it becomes negative. 3 on the other side, it becomes negative. Now this is minus 21x is equal to 22. Shift minus 21 on that side, the answer would be minus 22 upon minus 21. Bacho, this is your answer to the sum. Alright. Now let's start with the second one. first term, second term, third term, fourth term. Cool. Let us start with by using componendo dividendo. A cube plus 3ab square 3a square b plus b cube upon a cube plus 3ab square. Now this is first term plus second term, first term plus second term, and then first term minus second term. Now when I was using this minus second term, I immediately used a bracket here. Why I'm using a bracket? Because again, guys, as we've just seen, when you open the bracket, the signs would change. Now this is 536 plus 193, 536 minus 193. Now, if I open this bracket, this would be minus, minus 3a square b, and then here this is minus into plus, so this would also change to minus. So let us open this bracket, let us open this bracket, and this sign would change. So after opening the brackets, be careful, after opening the brackets the sign changes. Now let's see what are we left with. This is a cube plus 3ab square plus 3a square b plus b cube. This is a cube plus 3ab square minus 3a square b minus b cube. If you remember, in 9th standard you've gone through the formulas. If you remember, guys, this one is the formula for a plus b the whole cube upon a minus b the whole cube is equal to 536 plus 193 is 729, and 536 minus 193 is 343. So this is where you get. Now observe keenly, you will find that you have got all the numbers in terms of its cubes, a plus b the whole cube, a minus b the whole cube. 729 is a cube of 9, and 343 is a cube of 7. So when you do this, you find that you have got cubes on the left hand side and on the right hand side. So guys, now let us take cube root on both sides. Let us take cube root on both sides. So when you take cube root on both sides, you will get a plus b upon a minus b is equal to 9 upon 7. So what you are doing is taking cube root on both sides. Now after this step, you can either cross multiply and get the answer, or you can again use componendo dividendo and get the answer. Now what I'll do is I will actually use componendo dividendo and solve this. Why I'm doing this? Because I want you guys to know that there are no limitations as to how many times you can use componendo dividendo in a sum. You can use the property n number of times. So here again I am using componendo dividendo, and let us see what do we get. First term, second term, third term, fourth term. So this is first plus second, first, see, minus, now minus of this, so this will be minus a, minus of this, this will be plus b, which is equal to 9 plus 7 upon 9 minus 7. So this would be 2a, 2b, 16 upon 2, cancel, a upon b is equal to 8 upon 1. So, bachcho, this is your answer. A upon b is equal to 8 upon 1. Now, this is one way of doing the sum after this step. I'll solve it by the other way, which is comparatively simpler for you guys, because you will not actually recollect that again you need to use componendo dividendo. If you are not using componendo dividendo after this step, what do we get? Taking cube roots, we will get a plus b upon a minus b is equal to 9 upon 7. Taking cube root, beta, let us cross multiply. 7 a plus b is equal to 9 a minus b, 7a plus 7b is equal to 9a minus 9b. So now 7a plus 7b is equal to 9a minus 9b. Let us shift this 9a on this side and I'll get 7a minus 9a is equal to minus 9b minus 7b. This is minus 2a is equal to minus 16b. Shift b on this side and 2 on that side. From both the sides, minus gets cancelled. You are left with a upon b is equal to 16 upon 2. Therefore, your answer is a upon b is equal to 8 upon 1. So, I just used both the options that are available to us. After this step, either you can move ahead using the cross multiplication process, or you can again use componendo dividendo. Either which way you do it, you get the answer to be correct. Okay. So let us start with another kind of a question from ratio and proportion. We are given that p is equal to 4xy upon x plus y, and we got to find the value of this. Now, to begin with, what we'll do is, p is equal to 4xy upon x plus y, which is already given to us. Now, the value for which we are looking forward to, it is p plus 2x upon p minus 2x, p plus 2y upon p minus 2y. So what we'll do is, with this p, we don't have a 2x. Here we have a 2x. So we will divide both sides by 2x. Since we want 2x to be involved in the sum, we will divide both sides by 2x. And when you do this, this is what you get. P upon 2x is equal to 2x. So now from P, we have got p upon 2x. Now from p upon 2x, we need to get p plus 2x upon p minus 2x. So to get p plus 2x and p minus 2x, we will use componendo dividendo. P plus 2x. And we do the same thing on the right hand side. P plus 2x upon p minus 2x. 2y plus x plus y. And 2y minus x plus y. Now here you have done this. Divide both sides. By 2x. And here, using componendo dividendo. So we get p plus 2x upon p minus 2x
is equal to x plus 3y upon minus x plus y. This is your first result. When you open the bracket, the signs would change and then you would get this result, minus x and then plus y. This is your result one. Now proceed in the same manner. Again, consider the same thing. P is equal to 4xy upon x plus y. Now, since we want p plus 2y upon p minus 2y, we'll repeat the same procedure by using 2y. So divide both sides by 2y. And you get p upon 2y on cancellation 2x upon x plus y. This is divide both sides by. Now use component or dividendo again. Now component or dividendo means first, second, third, fourth. So by component or dividendo you get first plus second upon first minus second is equal to third plus fourth upon third minus fourth. Using component or dividend. So now p plus 2y, p minus 2y is equal to 3x plus y upon x minus y. Now this is your statement number second. So you've got statement first here, statement second here. Now next what you got to do is add this and this. That means you have to add this and this term. So in the next step we'll be adding these two terms, this one and this one, and that will give us our result. Okay guys, now p plus 2x, p minus 2x plus p plus 2y upon p minus 2y is equal to x plus 3y upon minus x plus y plus 3x plus y upon x minus y. Now let us take a common denominator and solve by taking LCM. Now you can see that in both the denominators there's a difference of just one sign. What you guys can do is, you can change this minus x plus y shift, take out minus s common. So minus x plus y becomes minus of x minus y, which is x plus 3y upon minus x minus y plus 3x plus y upon x minus y. Shift this negative sign in the numerator. And then take the LCM. Now since you have a common denominator, the LCM would remain the same. And here you would get plus 3x plus y.
So minus x minus 3y plus 3x plus y upon x minus y. So here this becomes 3x minus x, which is 2x minus 3y plus y, which is minus 2y upon x minus y. Take out 2s common. And your final answer is 2.
Okay, now for the next one, x is given as root a plus 3b plus root a minus 3b upon root a plus 3b minus root a minus 3b. And then you've got to prove this. Prove that this result is equal to 0. Now, since this is just x, what we'll do is we'll write this x upon 1, and that will solve all the issues that we have here. We'll write this x as x upon 1. So watch this. X upon 1 is equal to 1st that is 1st upon 2nd is equal to 3rd upon 4th. Now, let us use componendo dividendo here. When you use componendo dividendo here, what you get is 1st plus 2nd upon 1st minus 2nd is equal to 3rd plus 4th plus 3rd plus 4th upon 3rd minus 4th. So guys, you can see this. This is 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th. By using componendo, you get 1st plus 2nd upon 1st minus 2nd is equal to 3rd plus 4th upon 3rd minus 4th. Now this is what we've got by using componendo dividendo. Every time you use a property, you have to mention which property you have used. Now let us open up these brackets. X plus 1 upon x minus 1 is equal to under root a plus 3b plus under root a minus 3b plus under root a plus 3b minus under root a minus 3b under root a plus 3b under root a minus 3b. You got to write a lot of things here, but then you have to. Now minus, and then there's a bracket here. So when you open this bracket, and this, since there's a minus outside, the signs would change. So this will become minus under root a plus 3b, and here minus into minus, which is plus. So plus under root a minus 3b. Let us start the cancellation part. Under root a minus 3b is plus here. Under root a minus 3b is minus here. They'll both get cancelled. Under root a plus 3b is plus here. Under root a plus 3b is minus here. Both gets cancelled. So now you're left with x plus 1 upon x minus 1 is equal to twice of, double of under root a plus 3b, twice of under root a minus 3b, where this 2 gets cancelled. So you've cancelled this. So you have reduced the term. You have actually reduced the terms. From where we started, it was a long term, huge term. You have reduced it. Now you'll try to further reduce it. The reason why we are using component dividendo in most of the sums, we find that to reduce the sums, we use component dividendo all the while, all the time. Now again, we will use component dividendo for these four terms, first, second, third and fourth.
Okay.
So now we have read this x plus 1 upon x minus 1 is equal to under root a plus 3b upon under root a minus 3b. Now after this, what you do is, we can see that there are four terms and we have to use component dividendo, fine. But it's better to remove the root signs. In order to remove the root signs, what you'll do is, you'll take squaring on both sides. So this is a step where you have taken squaring on both sides. So this is x square plus 2x plus 1, x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to a plus 3b upon a minus 3b. So you have taken a square on both sides, and when you have taken a square on both sides, you have used the methods of expansion, a plus b the whole square, which is a square plus 2ab plus b square. After this step, again, we move on to use componendo dividendo. So by componendo dividendo, this is what we'll get. First term plus second term upon first term minus second term is equal to third term plus fourth term upon third term minus fourth term. By using componendo dividendo, let us open these brackets now and try to reduce the terms. X square plus 2x plus 1 plus x square minus 2x minus plus 1 upon x square plus 2x plus 1 minus x square plus 2x minus 1, which is a plus 3b plus a minus 3b upon a plus 3b minus a plus 3b. Let us start our cancellations. This goes off, this goes off, and this goes off. So we are left with 2x square plus 2. This is x square, 2x square plus 2. 2x and 2x, 4x is equal to, this goes, 2a upon 6b. Now, 2 is common here, take out 2 as common. Cancel this 2 and here as well. So we are left with x square plus 1 upon 2x
is equal to a upon 3b. Guys, cross multiply this and see what result do you get. 3b into x square plus 1 is equal to 2x into a. So this becomes 3bx square plus 3b is equal to 2ax. Shift this 2ax on this side. 3bx square minus 2ax plus 3b equals to 0. When this shifts on the other side, nothing is left on the this right hand side. So you are left only with 0. And you can see that you have got your result. Next kind of a sum that we have here is, there are three ratios which are equal. And we have to show that each ratio is equal to either half or minus 1. Each ratio is either half or minus 1. Now what we'll do here is, we will start from here, a upon b plus c is equal to b upon c plus a equals to c upon a plus b. And we will assume each ratio, see this is each ratio, we will assume each ratio to be k. We've taken a constant value for the three ratios. Since the values of all the three ratios is same, we can always assume it as a constant. So we have taken it as k. Now, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, see, there can be two conditions here. Since you want to get two answers, let us take two conditions. One is a plus b plus c is 0, and the other is if a plus b plus c, a plus b plus c is not equal to 0 and a plus b plus c is equal to 0. I have taken two different conditions. First, I am taking not equal to 0 and then I am taking equal to 0. Now, what happens here is, this is a constant. First ratio is equal to second ratio is equal to third ratio equals to constant. So, take this constant as sum of numerators upon sum of denominators. Now, I'll explain this part to you separately. Now, what happens, guys? Suppose you just think about it. Suppose you have three ratios and these three ratios are equal. Why they are equal? Because they all have a constant value of half. They all have a constant value of half. 2 upon 4 is half, 3 upon 6 is half, 5 upon 10 is half. So this is our constant. This is our constant. Now what we do is, we add up the numerators and the denominators. 2 plus 3 plus 5, 4 plus 6 plus 10, and then try to find out their values. 10 upon 20. Which is again half. That was the value for the constant. So you see that if three ratios are equal, if three ratios are equal and they get give you a value k, answer k, same way mein, if you add the three numerators and the three denominators, the answer that you'd get now will also be k. The answer that you get now will also be k. That's what I'm doing. Agar in teenon ratios ka value k hai bachcho, तो अगर मैं न्यूमरेटर्स और डिनोमिनेटर्स को ऐड भी करूंगा तो भी आंसर के ही आएगा. दैट इज द रीजन आई एम राइटिंग दिस एंड देन आई विल ऐड k इज इक्वल टू a प्लस b प्लस c. दीज आर द न्यूमरेटर्स एंड दीज आर द डिनोमिनेटर्स b प्लस c प्लस c प्लस a प्लस a प्लस b. Let us add it all here. A plus B plus C
upon 2a plus 2b plus 2c, which is a plus b plus c upon 2 a plus b plus c. This goes off and the answer that you get is half. Guys, now you can have a look. You have assumed each ratio equals to k. You have assumed each ratio equals to k, and this each ratio is now equals to half. तो बच्चों क्वेश्चन में भी यही पूछा था, शो दैट ईच रेशियो इज इक्वल टू हाफ. सो यू हैव गॉट ईच रेशियो इज इक्वल टू हाफ. सो फर्स्ट रिजल्ट इज प्रूव्ड. देयरफॉर ईच रेशियो इक्वल्स टू हाफ. दिस इज योर फर्स्ट रिजल्ट. नाउ इफ ए प्लस बी प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, लेट अस राइट इट दिस वे. लेट अस टेक द फर्स्ट रेशियो ए अपॉन बी प्लस सी. I have taken the first ratio, A upon B plus C, B upon C plus A, C upon A plus B. Now this value that we have here, B plus C, with this B plus C, we will add A plus B plus C. Since I have added an extra A here, I will subtract an extra A. B plus C, the same thing B plus C, I am writing it as A plus B plus C minus A. So I'll get A upon A plus B plus C. Now A plus B plus C, I have already taken it as 0. So I'll put it as 0 in the second condition. A plus B plus C, 0 upon minus A. Now 0 upon minus, 0 minus A. A upon minus A, the answer is minus 1. We can do the same thing for these two terms, these two fractions. Minus B, the answer is minus 1. So you can see that each time you are getting a, similarly you can get this is also minus 1. So you find that each ratio is minus 1. You have actually proved each ratio to be minus 1. First ratio, second ratio and third ratio. So you've got all the ratios to be minus 1. Well, now there are other kind of sums that you will come across in this chapter, wherein you will be given questions based on these. I mean, the first thing is, if we have four numbers in proportion, A, B, C and D are in four numbers in proportion. When there are four numbers in proportion, they can be written as A upon B is equal to C upon D. Four numbers are in proportion, first upon second is equal to third upon fourth. Assume the value of both the ratios to be K. A upon B is also K and C upon D is also K. Now when A upon B is K and C upon D is K, we will write A as BK and C as DK. So your A is BK and C is DK. These are the values which you get when you have four numbers in proportion. Now, you need to remember this part. If there are four numbers in proportion, then A is always equal to BK and C is always equal to DK. Guys, these are the kind of questions which you normally get. Show that this is equal to this when there are four numbers in proportion. When there are four numbers in proportion, you are asked to prove this.
What we will do is, we will start from the left hand side. LHS is A plus B upon C plus D, while RHS is under root 2A square plus 7B square under root 2C square plus 7D square.
Now, when four numbers are in proportion, we know that A is equal to BK and C is equal to DK. A is BK, C is DK. So, we have a value for A and we have a value for C. We have values for A and C. So, in place of A, I will write BK. In place of C, we will write DK. Let us take common in between both. So, B is K plus 1, D and then K plus 1. This goes off. The left hand side that remains is B upon D. This is your left hand side. Now, coming to the right hand side. Again, at the right hand side, you see that you have A square plus 7B square. Then you have C square 7D square. Bacho, once again, we have a value for A. We have a value for B. Let us substitute this value for A and C. We have a value for A and C. So, substitute A as BK, C as DK. So, we would get 2B square K square plus 7B square upon 2D square K square plus 7D square. This is what you have got here. From this numerator, let us take out b square as common. From the denominator, let us take out d square as common. So, here this would become b square as common under the root sign. Inside you've got 2k square plus 7 under the root sign. D square as common. 2k square plus 7. Both the terms are same. So, what you can write is under root b square upon d square into 2k square plus 7. 2k square plus 7, which gets cancelled. Now, under root b square upon d square is nothing but b upon d. So, we have left hand side as B upon D, right hand side as B upon D. Here we can write, therefore, LHS equals to RHS, hence proved. So, this is the first kind of a sum that we have done here. Alright. If A, B, C, D are in continued proportion, we get A upon B is equal to B upon C is equal to C upon D. And if these ratios are equal, the value of each ratio being K, now what you do is start from the extreme right. Take C upon D equals to K and you will get C is equal to DK. Now this is the first result that you have got. Now come to B upon C equals to K. So you will get B is equal to CK. After getting B is equal to CK, remember that C is already having a value DK. So in place of C, put DK. In place of C, put DK. So what you will get? B is equal to DK square. So B is equal to DK square. Here, A upon B is equal to K. Take A as equal to BK. Now check this. B is already equal to DK square. So in place of this B, put DK square. So A would be DK cube. So my dear students, when you have a question wherein it is mentioned that there are four numbers in continued proportion, there are four numbers in continued proportion, the result is always this. A is equal to DK cube, B is equal to DK square, and C is equal to DK. And this result you have to put in the question and solve. This is the question that we'll try to solve now. So in the LHS, we have under root AB plus BC minus CD. A is equal to DK cube. B is DK square. So we have a value for A and B. I put it as brackets again. B, we have a value for B. C, we have a value for C. Minus CD, we have a value for C. D, we don't have a value for D. So put D as it is. And then let us start substituting the values. So when you substitute the values, this is what you get. A, DK cube. B, DK square. B, DK square. C, DK. C, DK. After putting in the values, now let us multiply them. D into D is D square. K raised to 3 and K raised to 2 is K raised to 5. Plus D into D, D square, K cube, minus D square, K. Upon getting this, now start taking out whatever is common here. So when you start taking out whatever is common here, what you get is, this becomes D, it comes out. This is, when it comes out, becomes K square. What are you left with? Inside is just K. D square, D comes out, K square, K comes out. What you left with is K. Out of D square, D comes out. What you are left with is just K. So from these three, check what is common. We have D root K is common, D root K is common, D root K is common. So we'll write D root K, and inside we have K square plus K minus 1. So guys, this is your left hand side. After getting this left hand side, let us start solving the right hand side. Once again, A, we have a value. B, we have a value. C, we have a value. And then B, we have a value. C, we have a value. But D, we don't have a value. Let us substitute the values for A, B, C. Now A is how much? DK cube. B is DK square. C is DK. B is DK square. C is DK. Let us start solving and get the answer. DK cube plus DK square minus DK. What is common in all these three? It's DK. So inside you are left with K plus
k square plus k minus 1. Here, what is common? D is common. K square plus k minus 1 multiply dk into d, which is d square k, and these two brackets, they are same. So we write k square plus k minus 1 whole square. From under the root sign, take out only the square terms. So you will get d, k comes out, becomes root k, while this is k square plus k minus 1. What you see is LHS equals to RHS. Hence, proved. So observe the terms carefully, because there are a lot of terms involved, a lot of substitutions are involved, and be very clear while doing the substitution part. Because you make the slightest of mistake in putting the values dk cube, dk square or dk in the correct places, the sum may go wrong. So avoid doing that and just be very clear while substitutions of values. Okay guys, now we have three numbers A, B, C, and these three numbers are in continued proportion. If we have three numbers in continued proportion, we write them as first upon second is equal to second upon third. The first upon second is equal to second upon third. Let us assume it as k. So we would get a upon b equals to k and b upon c equals to k. So we will get b is equal to ck. And then A is equal to BK. Now this B, we already have a value for B, which is CK. So substitute the value of B as CK here. And we'll get A is equal to CK square. So A is equal to CK square, B is equal to CK. This is the result that we get. Secondly, there is one more aspect to it. I'll explain that aspect as well. If I have A upon B is equal to B upon C, and if I don't consider the two values, the two ratios as K, and I simply cross multiply. Now, when I simply cross multiply, I get b into b, which is b square, and a into c, which is ac. So, this is another result which you get from this same question, b square is equal to ac. Here, when you get b square is equal to ac, we say that b is the geometric mean or mean proportional of A and C. So remember this, when you have three numbers in continued proportion, you can take either of these two results. Either you can take A is equal to CK square, B is equal to CK, or you can also write B square is equal to AC, where B is called as the geometric mean or the mean proportional of A and C. Now, using one of these results, we'll try to solve this. In the next question, we have B is the mean proportional between A and C. Now, when B is the mean proportional between A and C, we can take A as CK square and B as CK. When B is the mean proportional, it means that A upon B is equal to B upon C. If A upon B is equal to B upon C and both are equal to K, we can consider these results A is CK square and B is equal to CK. Now let us solve the LHS and show that it is equal to RHS. LHS is A square minus B square plus C square upon A raised to minus 2 minus B raised to minus 2 plus C raised to minus 2 and the RHS that we have here is just B raised to 4. So we'll try to solve the LHS and show that it is also equals to B raised to 4. We have a value for A, we have a value for B, we do not have a value for C. So start writing it this way: A square minus B square plus C square upon A raised to minus 2 B raised to minus 2 plus C raised to minus 2. In place of A, substitute the value that you have for A, which is CK square B CK A CK square B CK. Open the brackets, each one of them. So you get C square K4 minus C square K square plus C square upon C raised to minus 2 K raised to minus 4 minus C raised to minus 2 K raised to minus 2 plus C raised to minus 2. Now let us take out C raised common from the numerator. C raised to 2 K4 minus K square plus 1. From the denominators, let us take out C raised to minus 2 K raised to minus 2 K raised to minus 4 as common. Now let's see, if I take out K raised to minus 4 as common, what am I left with inside? Now I want to get C raised to minus 2 K raised to minus 2 and I have C raised to minus 2 and K raised to minus 4 already taken out as common. Bacho, I want to get this. I have already taken out this as common. Now what should I multiply this to get this? To get this, what should I multiply this? I will have to multiply this with K square. Now when I multiply this with K square, I will get this result. K raised to minus 4 and K raised to plus 2 will be K raised to minus 2. So here, when I take out C raised to minus 2 and K raised to minus 4 as common, first I'll put 1 inside the bracket. Then for the second term, the only common is K square. Let us take out K square, which comes inside the bracket. Now the third thing is C raised to minus 2. Now I want to get C raised to minus 2, where I have already taken C raised to minus 2 and K raised to minus 4 as common. Now what should I multiply this with? Isse hum kisse multiply karenge to C raised to minus 2 milega. Just think about it. So you will obviously multiply this with K raised to 4. So when you multiply this with K raised to 4, obviously you will get C raised to minus 2. So yahan par you will get K raised to 4. So this is how you take common. Look at the numerator and the denominator. In the numerator and the denominator, what you get? These two brackets are same. K4 plus K4 plus K4 minus K square plus 1. Cancel. Shift both the terms in the numerator. Shift both the terms in the numerator. So what you'll get? C square into C raised to minus 2 and K raised to minus 4. So this will be C4 K4. Now this is your left hand side. Now in the right hand side we only have V4. So in the right hand side, since we have V4, we will write it as B. B can be written as CK. The value of B is CK, which will be C4, K4. Now this is your RHS. Therefore, LHS equals to RHS. Hence, proved. So this sum gets over like this. Here, there is a catch. While taking out common in the denominator, be very clear and specific, because you need to take out the very first term as common, though it is not present in the next two terms. You have to modify the next two terms and take out the first term as common, only then cancellation would happen. Okay guys, so this is Professor Arif Khan in association with Sinhal's classes. I'm signing off for now. This was ratio and proportion for you. Basically, we've done all the important kind of sums which are normally asked in your exams. So just don't fear. We are here. Take care. Bye-bye.